DVD Era TV back at y'all with another one. Y'all know the slogan. Today we gonna talk about the time Loon and 40 Cal had an altercation in a barbershop. Now let's get into it.
Mixtapes and DVDs is my era.
Facts.
We did it better.
Yep.
Pelly Pelly leathers.
Facts.
ACG boots. We 80s babies.
Woo.
In early 90s when it got grimy. I was out of this world, you could not find me. Unless you checked the lobby, hustling was my hobby. We was lobby boys,
yep,
before Jim Jones. You could catch me in Harlem eating Jim Bones.
It's your boy 40 Cal, newest member of Dipset.
Now, Loon is a rapper from Harlem, New York. Around 1989, Loon migrated to L.A. because all the trouble he was getting in and NY. While Loon was in L.A., he became a member of the Crips and also got his name Loony from all the work he was putting in. After returning to Harlem, Loon would eventually start writing poetry, which eventually led to him pursuing a rap career. Loon would get his first record deal around 1996 with Tommy Boy Records, but became more known after becoming a member of Mace rap group Harlem World. It wouldn't be until Loon signed to P. Diddy's Bad Boy Records when Loon would get his big mainstream success, putting out radio-friendly records like I Need a Girl 1 and 2 and Down For Me featuring Mario Winans. Now in the DVD era, Loon appeared on the Real Talk DVD where he aired out fellow Harlem rappers Mace, K-Ron, and Jim Jones, stating that they were just rappers and they didn't really live the lifestyle they were promoting in their music. After this DVD was released with Loon spilling his feelings about some of his peers from Harlem, this has started back and forth with mainly Loon and Jim Jones and a few other members of Dipset. Loon and Jim Jones would get on DVDs like Sub-Zero and trade jabs with one another. This would eventually lead to Loon having problems with other Dipset members J.R. Ryder and 40 Cal, who Loon once had a relationship with. Now, according to Loon, he says he actually was the first person to help 40 Cal record around 15 songs in the studio. But due to Loon problems with Dipset at this time, Loon and 40 Cal will fall out and eventually have an altercation that was well documented in the DVD era. Now, supposedly, Loon seen 40 Cal in a barbershop that they both went to in Harlem. Now, while 40 Cal is sitting down getting the shape up, Loon grabs a shovel and start to hit 40 Cal with it. But 40 Cal doesn't remember the situation going that way. So this is an article from 40 Cal with HipHopDX.com explaining the whole situation with him and Loon inside the barbershop. I'ma tell y'all the real story, cause I'm a real dude. I'm in a barbershop. Me and Loon got the same barber. He's from the hood. Prior to the incident I'm about to explain, I ain't seen Loon in like 2 years. I heard he moved to Atlanta or something, so I'm getting my hair lined up or whatever by the barber. Here comes Loon walking in. He walks and talks to some of the barbers. They all cool. It's like the show, the shop. You feel what I'm saying? Everybody know each other and all that. Just cool. I'm getting my cut and Loon comes in and says my name like in a joking way. Like, yo, 40. Like, he's saying what up to me. I said nothing. I continue getting my cut. He's mad with a couple people in back of me. I don't know. They talking or whatever. Loon is in back of them. He grabs a shovel from the closet and out of nowhere he swings while I'm getting lined up and hits me in the shoulder. So I get up looking at him and he swings, but I block it with my arm and snuff him. He dropped the shovel and I threw him in the chairs. He's under me because I threw him in the chairs. He tries to pick me up. He almost picks me up, but I snuff him again. So he dropped me. He falls off me, then dudes break it up. I tell Loon, let's take it outside. Let's fight again. Like, you know, let's get it over with. You got something on your chest? Loon grabs the shovel again. I say, you can't fight without the shovel? This guy drops the shovel and go runs and jump in some little hoopty. I didn't start laughing. I'm still mad at what's going on. I just go finish getting my lineup and call a few of my guys and call it a day. He wasn't nowhere to be found for the day. That's the story. I mean, if a dude want to get points off that because he mad at Jimmy, so he try to get at me and try to get a point, he get nothing. He lost points. I heard he broke his pinky after the whole incident. He got a few marks on his face or something from a couple jabs I gave him. Me? There's nothing wrong with me. Like, it's verified. I done took a few pictures. I'm about to make another video. I might make another mixtape called On Beat Me In My Head Volume 1. I'll see him when I see him. It's nothing, you dig? Now, after the whole altercation with Loon and 40 Cal, they both would get on hip-hop DVDs and talk about the situation. Now, actually, after this whole altercation too, They were on Hot 97 live on air speaking about the situation with DJ Envy and Miss Jones. So basically they was live on air on the phone explaining what happened in their fight at the barbershop. Now, after they were on air at Hot 97, 40 Cal would drop a diss record called Rockabye Baby, Getting That Loon. Now, after the whole back and forth live on Hot 97 with Loon and 40 Cal, and after 40 Cal put out his diss record towards Loon, when Loon was on these underground hip-hop DVDs and they asked him about the fight with 40 Cal, he'd kind of shy away from the question and act like it had never happened. You get what I'm saying? He was looking at it from a perspective as, like, he don't have a squeaky clean record, and what happens in the streets is staying in the street.
And, dog, stop making all these statements talking about hit you with a shovel and did all this shit to you, B. I ain't do nothing to you.
Now, even though Loon kind of stopped talking about these street situations on these hip-hop DVDs, he would still put out a mixtape for The Wizard of Harlem, which was like a mixtape album. And on this mixtape album, he had a diss record for Jim Jones called Jimmy. Now, on that same mixtape, the outro was actually him and 40 Cal at Hot 97 speaking about their fight that they had in the barbershop. Now, on November 22, 2011, Loon was arrested while on a trip to Brussels. He was extradited back to the U.S. in May 2012 and sentenced to 14 years on July 2013 for conspiracy with intent to traffic one or more kilos of heroin. Due to the COVID pandemic, Loon was granted an early release on July 29, 2020. Now, Loon is currently following his Muslim beliefs, and he's currently living his life as a righteous, God-fearing man. So shout out to Loon. But anyway, this is just a classic little hip-hop story from them DVD eras. If you're a fan of these old hip-hop stories, tell a friend and tell a friend about my page. Like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. More content coming, and I'm out. One.